I'm Brandon Corley.
And I'm Mercedes Egan.
And this is your school news.
We will have your school updates, but first, here's Elena with your hour-by-hour forecast. Elena?
Here's your hour-by-hour forecast for this afternoon. By 1 p.m., 65, then by 3 p.m., 69, then by 5 p.m., 70. Now taking a look at your current weather. In Aiken, 63, in Augusta, 64, and in Swainsboro, 65. Have your five-day forecast coming up. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Elena. Students, please remember that tomorrow we do have school, for tomorrow is a makeup snow day.
Seniors, ring, cap, and gown delivery will be on Tuesday, April 1st, from 8 to 11 a.m. Also, students who have missed ordering their class rings, order makeups will be from 11 to 12:15.
Wear crazy socks tomorrow to support Down syndrome. And now it's time for Real Talk. Real news, real solutions.
For those of us who depend upon the canteen for lunch every day, you might be very disappointed with all that's going away. Here's Jeremy with your canteen changes.
For everyone who uses the canteen for their lunch, here's a heads up about a change that's going to start taking place next year.
Starting next year, 2015-2016, what changes will be held in the canteen area?
Well, for DECA, it's going to be big changes because we can no longer sell pizza, we can't sell Brewster's, our store, we can't sell candy, anything that has high calorie value for children. So that's our fundraising. It's going to be really bad for us as far as funds.
Okay, can you tell us why these changes are being made?
Well, it's being directed from the State Department, South Carolina State, which is driven by the national campaign with the fight for a race to eliminate obesity in children.
I'm sure you'll find a good lunch with these changes. For Real Talk, I'm Jeremy Harris. Back to you.
We'll have your five-day forecast and your box office preview shortly after the break.
Awareness of how hurtful the R word truly is.
Spread the word to end the R word.
Baby love, it should be easy. It shouldn't be complicated. It should be easy.
Audio Jungle.
5-day forecast. Friday, 73. Saturday, 77. Sunday, 69. Monday, 57. And Tuesday, 52. So it's going to be cooling down again for the beginning part of next week. And also we have some rain chances coming back. On Monday, a 20% chance of rain. The rain chances will increase through Monday night, and then a 30% chance of rain on Tuesday. By the way, today's the first day of spring. If you don't know, spring starts today. Along with longer days comes warmer weather. Trees and flowers are in full bloom. According to meteorologists, spring will be a slow transition throughout the country, except Florida. Throughout spring, the Southeast will have average rainfall, but the West will be in a drought. Severe weather will be more eventful than 2013, but will still be below average. For Real Talk, I'm Elena Berry. Back to you.
Thanks, Elena. It's allergy season again, and with pollen everywhere, we could all use a few helpful tips on how to stay protected. Here's Bruce with more.
Did you know about 10 to 20% of Americans suffer from allergies? The itching, sneezing, coughing, and runny nose can be worse at some times than others, depending on your particular allergy. But pollen is in the air, and your friends here at Real Talk want to keep you healthy.
And if you know what triggers your allergies, is to avoid it. Wash your hands frequently with soap and water. Stay away from people that have colds. You wash your hands frequently. And there are medications that you can take. If you know you have severe allergies or they act up, you can take a Claritin or a Zyrtec, and some people take Dimetapp daily just in case so they don't act up.
Keep your hands off your face and be sure to use soap in the bathroom. I'm Corey Bruce. Back to you.
Thanks, Bruce. And now it's time for the segment that everyone knows and loves. Here's Dennis D with our box office previews and the top 10 songs in the Billboard 200. Dennis?
Start things off with the movies. Check out these new films in theaters this weekend.
They took everything from me. I do not fear, for you are with me. All those who defied me shall be ashamed and disgraced. Those who wage war against me shall perish. I will find strength, find guidance, and I will triumph.
After being released from prison for a crime that he did not commit, street racer Toby Marshall is set to race cross-country and to avenge the death of his friend Pete. See Need for Speed, now in theaters.
You nervous?
Who are you? For your test?
No, I was terrified.
The only way our society can survive is for each of you to claim your rightful place. Today, you will take a test that will help you discover who you truly are. The future belongs to those who know where they belong.
An adventure set in a future world where people are divided into distinct factions based on their personalities, Tris Prior is warned she is divergent and will never fit into any one group. When she discovers a conspiracy to destroy all divergents, she must find out what makes being divergent so dangerous before it's too late. Divergent will be in theaters March 21st.
The world's greatest criminal has stolen the greatest treasures, escaped the greatest prisons, and he bears a strong resemblance to someone you know.
It's not easy being mean.
It's Constantine, the world's most dangerous frog.
Check this out.
Oh, look, it's Kermit.
What did you do with Kermit? There must be some mistake. I'm Kermit the Frog. I'm not Constantine.
You're going to be here a while.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here.
Kermit the Frog here.
Mayhem follows the Muppets overseas as they find themselves unwittingly entangled in an international crime caper headed by Constantine, the world's number one criminal, and a dead ringer for Kermit, and his deathly sidekick, Dominic, aka Number Two. Muppets Most Wanted will be in theaters March 21st. Now switching over to music, here's the top 3 albums of the Billboard 200. At number 3 on the Billboard, we have Beck and his album, Morning Phase. At number 2 is the soundtrack from the new film, Frozen. And number 1 on the Billboard 200 is Schoolboy Q with the album, Oxymoron. I'm Dennis D, and this has been Box Office and Music Reviews.
Thank you, Dennis. Daylight savings is now in full effect, so we took the initiative to inform you the changes it has on your sleeping habits. Here's Malcolm with more.
Thanks, Mercedes. Most of us upperclassmen who have jobs look forward to this part of the day more than anything else, sleep. Most of us don't mind giving up an hour of sleep, being that we have fair weather and longer days in the springtime. However, this hour setback can have a long-term effect on your health.
Most people who fail to adjust properly to the setback are often tired earlier in the day and have trouble focusing. For students, this can result in lower test and quiz grades, and nobody wants that. If staying up late at night is a habit, a good way to get that sleep back is by taking naps after school.
Keeping these tips in mind, make sure you be responsible and go to bed on time. I'm Malcolm Ivory, back to you, Mercedes.
Thank you, Malcolm, and thank you for watching. I'm Brandon Corley.
And I'm Mercedes Egan.
And this has been your school news.